In Parshat Ve'etchanan, this week's parsha, we're introduced to Shema Yisrael, the passages that speak about our faith and fidelity to God. In the Tractate of Psachim, it speaks about a conflict of how to recite these passages in our prayer services. Perhaps the way it is found in the Bible, Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, followed by the words V'ahavta et Hashem Elokecha, Hear, O Israel, the Lord is one, and we love God, and we want to know God, engage God. Or should we recite these passages the way it happens by Jacob's deathbed? The Talmud explains that Jacob gathers his children around his deathbed. He wants to share the prophecy of when the Messiah will come. He's unable to do that. He fears that, like his father Isaac, and his grandfather, Avraham, it's because his home is incomplete. Abraham had Ishmael, and Isaac had Esav. Immediately, his children in unison answer, Shema Yisrael, Israel, Jacob, we are one. We are totally committed to God. And he responds, Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'olam Ve'ed, that God's name and what he represents is eternal in my family. The Talmud resolves this conflict with a compromise. The biblical text of the Etchanan we should recite out loud. And we should whisper, Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'olam Ve'ed. And that's what we do. Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad, we recite out loud. Then we utter in a whisper, Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'olam Ve'ed. And then we articulate again, V'ahavta et Hashem Elokecha. V'chol levavcha, v'chol nafshecha, v'chol meldecha. Rabbi Soloveitchik recognized the fact that we do something more than just whisper the peace that is found just in the dialogue of Jacob and his children. We actually collapse the dialogue into a monologue. In the story of Jacob, the children recite Shema Yisrael, and Jacob recites Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto. We collapse that dialogue into a monologue. And he explains the reason is that when we recite the Shema of Parshat Ve'etchanan, we play the role of two different characters. We first play the role of Jacob's children, Shema Yisrael, Hear, O Israel, Hear the Jewish people, Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. We are committed to being the children of Israel. We are committed to the tradition. We are committed to the values of what it means to study and to find a relationship with God. But then we merge in a whisper to also becoming not just the children of Israel, but acting like Jacob the teacher. Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'olam Ve'ed. We also have to be able to take on the mantle of leadership, to teach the vision of Judaism to our family, to ourselves, to our community, and to society. We play both roles. We're the student, Shema Yisrael, and we are Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto. We are this teacher. We need to be both. Shabbat Nachamu, the Shabbat of comfort, requires us to play both roles. It requires us to pursue the role of student, of constantly engaging and renewing our relationship to God, but never allowing that to stop us from also being the teacher in making our families better, in making our community better, and making our society better. Nachamu, Nachamu, Ami. We will be comforted. We will be redeemed when we take on both of these responsibilities, the responsibility of being the student and simultaneously the responsibility of being the teacher, the responsibility of saying Shema Yisrael and also being the teacher of guaranteeing Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'olam Ve'ed. Shabbat Shalom.